Give it up for Common and Kanye West.
It's common sense. Kanye West on the Dave Chappelle show. Everybody gotta eat right, y'all. It's the food, baby.
Yo, I walked in the crib, got two kids and my baby mama.
For real, this time.
The Healthy Hunger-Free Kids Act, introduced by Michelle Obama, changed the nutrition standards for the National School Lunch Program by requiring schools to serve more fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and fat-free and low-fat milk. Furthermore, it limited the amount of high-sodium and trans-fat foods that can be sold in lunches. However, since the Obama era, the U.S. Department of Agriculture has altered the nutrition standards in 2018 to limit the amount of required whole grains and increase the allowed amount of sodium and trans fat in flavored milk. In 2020, the requirements were changed again, this time lowering the overall serving size of vegetables students had to consume weekly. These new changes are threatening to the positive impacts that the Obama rules have made. According to Kelsey Kindernick, a graduate student pursuing a master's in public health, with the recent changes loosening the standards of food, these particular gains are at risk of being lost, especially for low-income students who receive greater nutrition content from school rather than anywhere else.
On the other hand, many students claim that the changes made by Michelle Obama are ruining their school lunches and deserve to be reversed. A study conducted by the Harvard School of Public Health found that 60% of vegetables and 40% of fresh fruit are thrown away. Students throughout the United States blame Michelle Obama for this phenomenon, claiming that the new school lunches are flavorless and sad. This has led to a significant increase in waste. A World Wildlife Fund report estimated that in the United States, school food waste totals 530,000 tons per year and costs as much as $9.7 million a day to manage. In order to combat this, the Food Waste Warriors program has been implemented in several cities across the United States to try and cut down food waste. After 6 weeks, the program lowered the trash output by 3%.
Beings and am I? What's am I to a king? What's a king to a god? What's a god to a non-believer who don't believe in anything?
My job is I'm the cook for Clement Allen High School.
The food sold at Clement Allen High School is very good. Everything that we sell, we eat. You try it. If I cook it, I'm going to taste it first.
Fleming Island High School serves hot lunch daily. The cafeteria offers three options. Clay favorites include a chicken sandwich or chicken nuggets, the Smart Mouth pizza, and a third option, which changes daily but is usually a Tex-Mex variant. Elementary school lunches cost $2.25, and the secondary and high school lunches are sold for $2.50. However, there's a reduced price option for lower income students, which can be granted through an application process.
How often do you buy school lunch?
I buy it every day.
I get school lunch every day.
I don't.
I eat school lunch every day.
I buy one when I forget my lunch.
What is a typical school lunch for you?
I just buy, like, they got new pizza, so I like buy that every day.
Chicken sandwich.
Oh, I don't eat. I just go to the library.
Great.
Chicken. But, you know, I feel like the school likes to offer the kids a lot of chicken because it's nutritious and it's cheap for the school.
I usually pack my lunch from home.
Yeah. A chicken sandwich.
I don't eat lunch at the school.
How much food do you assume is wasted weekly?
Wow, that's a hard question. I think that there's probably a lot of fruit that's wasted. We get a truck every Wednesday morning. We believe there's quite a bit of waste.
Fleming Island has four separate lunch periods to accommodate the over 2,000 students who go through lunch every day. Students are required to grab a fruit, but it is usually disregarded and thrown out at the end of lunch. Styrofoam trays and pizza boxes also add to the already large amounts of waste produced. Surrounding elementary schools, such as Thunderbolt Elementary, use plastic reusable lunch trays which cut back on the non-edible waste. However, this is not a feasible solution for Fleming Island due to the sheer amount of students.
How much do you enjoy the school food offered at Fleming Island High?
It's kind of ass sometimes. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, I like it. Or not most of the time. It's like 50-50.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes it's not.
I don't really eat it, but it really doesn't look good at all. So.
Oh, when I'm not cutting weight, it's pretty good. It tastes pretty good.
You know, it depends on what they're serving. If it's like chicken tenders, it's pretty good. But if it's like the orange chicken, it's kind of bad.
Not very often.
10 out of 10 for school lunch, actually. For school lunch, for school
lunch. School lunch, underrated. It's pretty, it's good.
I've never gotten food from the school.
Would you say it's priced well for the standard of the food?
My mom will put me on that cheaper lunch stuff. Because she didn't feel like paying, so I don't really pay for lunch.
Yeah, it seems fair.
I don't think it is because the quality is so low. It shouldn't be, priced as much as it is.
Okay, so it's not priced well at all?
To be honest, I'm not sure how much the school lunch is because I never checked, but it shouldn't be worth more than, I'd say, $1.50 per meal. So if that's what it costs, then it's a good price.
I really don't, yeah, no.
I don't know how it's priced because I've never gotten it, but it seems okay.
Ready for it. Ready for it.
What do you think could be changed in order to improve American school lunch?
I think we should be like Texas and we should have restaurants inside of our cafeteria, like McDonald's.
Just being better, I don't know.
Probably make them healthier because it seems like we're trying to appeal to kids, but it's really not working. It's not good quality at all.
Funding. The thing Michelle Obama did, where she had the healthier food, that food apparently was great prior to that. So I think we go back on that. I think we need more options and more quality.
I think we need a... Do we think about this one? I need to think about this one.
I think the food needs to be more fresh to make it more healthy and just to have a better taste.
Free food, honestly, and I want more breakfast for me.
I don't know.
Some students have opinions on what can be improved about school lunches. However, it's important to keep in mind that school lunches are not a fine dining experience. Cafeteria staff work hard to produce school lunch that fuels our minds and bodies for the day. To add on, you get what you pay for, and the stigma that school lunches are subpar should be broken. School lunches have high nutritional value due to laws in place, so however aggravating a soggy sandwich may seem, for some students, it's the only healthy hot meal available. To summarize, it's important to be grateful for the food served in the cafeteria, but there are definitely some improvements that can be made. Some suggestions include having more options, which is a good idea. In particular, this is an American problem. Lunches served outside of the US are not only healthy, but also more appetizing and have more variation. For example, in France, the lunches served provide students with fresh ingredients. This includes fruits and meats, which are less processed and of higher quality. Students are more satisfied with these meals compared to the American opinion on school lunches. It may take a while, but Clay County and other school systems in the U.S. should work towards improving the school lunches served. The meals given to students are a vital part of the student's day. And sustenance creates success.
Honestly, this chicken is hella dry. I need to cook it better.